Hello guys, welcome back to your favorite agricultural and agribusiness YouTube channel. On today's episode, we are going to be looking at the 20 most frequently asked questions about plantain farming or banana farming. So on today's episode, we are going to be addressing 20 most common questions. People who usually want to go into plantain farming or even plantain farmer usually ask. So it will be bothering about question about how to do it best, where to do it, when to do it, things to avoid and the challenges and how to overcome them. So without wasting much of your time, the number one most frequently asked question about plantain is that when is the best time for you to establish a plantain farm? So the answer to this question is that if you don't have irrigation, you don't have a water source for your farm, the best time for you to establish your plantain farm is when the rain is already established or by the middle of the rain period of the year. I don't want to give you a month because of climate change. So, but if you are somebody who have the resources, you can do irrigation or you want to do irrigation, plantain is even best if you can do it with irrigation, because you'll be able to do some manipulation for you to harvest your product at the time whereby the plantain will command higher prices in the market. So that is that about that. So another set of question is that what is the best type of irrigation for plantain farming? The best type of irrigation for plantain farming, considering the spacing of plantain, is the drip irrigation. If you want to use irrigation on your farm, the best that will serve the purpose, that will not waste your water, and that will not encourage weed emergence on your farm, is drip irrigation. It might be expensive, but that is just the best. So another question that people usually ask, particularly in newcomers into the plantain farming industry, is that what is the best spacing for plantain farming? So I have a video where I discussed that, but the most advisable spacing is either 3x3 or 2.5x2.5. I usually recommend 2.5x2.5. So the next question will now be, what is the optimum population? How many plantain can I have on my 1 acre? So for example, if you are using 2.5 meter by 2.5 meter, so you will be having about 640-650 plantain trees on your farm. So another question that so many people also used to ask is that, what are the ways by which I can make money from my plantain farm? So there are two ways by which you can make money from your plantain farm, and one of the ways is that you plant your plantain, you establish your plantain farm, you take care of it, it mature, you cut the bunches, you take it to the market or you process it, you make money from that. Another way by which you can make money from your plantain farming is by the sale of your sucker. Plantains are regenerative in nature. What I mean by that is that when you plant a single sucker now, by the end of the fifth month of that plant, you will see that that single plantain sucker you planted on your farm will bring some offspring. Those are the ones you will uproot and you will sell to people who wants to establish their own new farm. So another common question about plantain farming is, how long should I expect? What is the maturity date? Or what is the maturity? How many months will it take for me to harvest my plantain? This is a very, very dicey question to address, because the maturity of your plantain depends on so many factors. It depends on the species you are planting. It depends on the age or the type of sucker you are using. Now, but on an average level, plantain will take within 10 months to 12 months for you to harvest. It will take within 10 months to 12 months for you to harvest your plantain. So another common question about plantain is that, can I do intercropping on my plantain farm? The answer is yes, and the answer is no. The answer is yes, and the answer is no. The answer is yes, because it is possible for you to do intercropping, particularly in your first year. That is the only time, me particularly, I will advise you to do intercropping. Yes, that is the only time I can advise you to do intercropping on your plantain farm, because at that time there will not be canopy on your farm. So you can intercrop maize, you can intercrop potato, you can intercrop pepper, or so many other things. But from the second year upward, it is not really visible, and it is not really that profitable. So another question is, what are the challenges in plantain farming? Just like any other crop, plantain also have its own challenges, and one of the challenges is the issue of disease and pest. So the most common disease that affects plantain is the Panama disease, though it's a very, very deadly disease, and it's not that common like that. But any farm this disease enters, it will go ahead and finish that type of farm. And plantain is also have this challenge with nematode. It's a crop that nematode affect a whole lot. So if you are going into plantain farming, I will advise you to treat your sucker, with nematicide and insecticide. So another common question before I forget is that people will ask you, where is the best location, or where are the places I can do my plantain farming? What I can say today is that plantain require a sandy, loamy, and deep soil. Any place you find a sandy loam, fertile, and deep soil, you can actually do plantain farming there. So another question so many people will also ask is that, can we do pruning in our plantain? Yes, we can do pruning, but it has to be done in a very cautious way. You have to be very, very cautious about it. It's not that you just carry your cutlass and over prune. If you over prune, it will affect the photosynthetic capacity of the tree. And if you do that during the dry season, you might end up noticing that your plantain trees are drying up, because that trees, those leaves also provide a kind of protection to the trunk. So if you are pruning, make sure you only prune diseased leaf or diseased branch or old leaf, so as to bring a kind of free airflow under your plantain farm. So another common question about our plantain farming is that, what is the best type of fertilizer for plantain farm? So the best type of fertilizer for plantain farm, plantain are heavy feeders. What that means is that they take a whole lot of nutrients away from the soil, and they are more particular about phosphorus and potassium. So any type of fertilizer blend you are using, make sure it contains this particular nutrient. They have need for other nutrients, but particularly phosphorus and potassium is very important. But plantain tends to react. Plantain tends to perform better when you are using a well-cultured organic manure, like the poultry waste. So, because that one will stay longer in the soil, and that is exactly what plantain needs to perform very well. If you have gotten value from this video, kindly give it a like, share with your friends, and drop a comment in the comment section. If you have not subscribed to this channel, kindly click on subscribe button to have access to more of my videos. And in case you are watching for the first time, this channel is dedicated to promote sustainable and profitable agriculture. Thank you for your time, and see you on the next one. Sheshe.